everyone, again. This time we are actually going to play Elgar, promise. But before we start, I was just thinking quite a lot this week about why we were doing these and why we started off. It seems like quite a long time ago. And there was this point in the middle of March where like everything stopped, and suddenly there was no music live happening anymore, and I spent I don't know how many hours in meetings trying to figure out what we were going to do with undergraduate recitals and things like that, and all these assumptions that I'd had like just came crashing down, like simple things like assuming that everybody had somewhere they could practice without somebody complaining about it, or that everybody had a piano that they could get to, and then sort of realizing that like how important it was, not just playing by yourself, but how important the role of the collaborative artist performer was, and how lucky I was to have. Not to have, to live with somebody like Hilary. And we do play together, but we didn't actually play together that often until this. And so I think we wanted to, because we could, and we suddenly realized how privileged and how lucky we were, I mean, to have that thing, and for me to have her, to be able to do this, and be like, you know, like music can still happen in spite of all this nonsense. And then since then, obviously, there have been so many really creative, really interesting ways that people have found to get around the problems of not often being able to be in the same room as the other person you're playing with. And the reason I was thinking about it was because this week would have been final recital week at the University of York. And I would have spent this week doing the best marking job in the world, where I would just sit all day and listen to the students' recitals, and quite often not even have to write anything about them, and just talk to my colleagues about them. And it literally is the best week of the year. And I remembered my final recital when I was an undergraduate, and how important it was, and like how devastating it was for us when we realised that actually we had no choice but to cancel these recitals, and how much more devastating it must have been for all the students. And so I don't hold with them with dedicating concerts, because I find it a bit sentimental and mawkish. But I'm going to be a bit sentimental and mawkish and dedicate this performance to all the York final recitalists who would have been playing this week, and all the first and second years who I would have been hearing next week, and that, you know, we're going to, you're going to come back and play your recitals for us at some point next year when we can all get in a room together and listen to people play, and I can't wait until that happens. But in the meantime, here is some Elgar. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, everyone. See you next week.